What's up, vinyl community? Cliff the Vinyl Cheapskate here, coming at you with another vinyl tag video. I swear, I'm almost done with the vinyl tags, I promise. Doing Tommy Vinyl Knots. Tommy the Vinyl Knot, I'm doing his vinyl tag, his punk vinyl tag, 2023. And if you know me, you know my bread and butter is punk music, punk rock, hardcore, heavy metal, all that kind of stuff. So, had to do the punk vinyl tag. Had to happen. Tommy set that up, so, and also the homie set it up, so had to do it for the homie. But anyway, got 20 questions to answer, so it's going to take a little bit, so let's get started on this one. First off, what we're listening to Detestation, Scald Records, crusty stuff from the late 90s, early 2000s. I think it's more late 90s. I think they're more 90s. I don't think they made it too far into the 2000s. I'm not 100% on that, though. But great band, crusty, kind of thrashy, hardcore punk, great stuff. Female vocals, excellent stuff. But anyway, let's get to the questions. First question. I've got them written down here because I didn't memorize 20 questions. Best punk record of 2022. So these are two of my favorite punk records of 2022. One, I pulled a 7-inch and a full length. So we'll do 7-inch and a full length. 7-inch is going to be the Mess Chisel Split. This is an excellent record. Chisel has done no wrong whatsoever. Same with Mess. Mess does no wrong whatsoever either. Both kind of do like a play on 80s oi sound, like early 80s oi sound. But Chisel has like a little more hardcore punk edge, and Mess has a little more melodic edge. But both are good, well written, great stuff. But Mess Chisel Split, that'll be my first pick. Next pick, my full length for best, this is my best album of the year, would be Long Knife, Curb Stomp Earth. Long Knife does really like, they're a Portland band, very highly influenced by Poison Idea, but with a little bit of a darker tinge, like a little gothy dark tinge in this record at least. Their other records, they have like some psychedelic parts and stuff like that. This one, they really did like dig into like a darker goth feel to it, but still with holding on to like a really good hardcore punk edge. Great record. Great record. That's Long Knife, Curb Stomp Earth. This is an excellent record. If you get a chance to check this out, definitely one of my favorites from 2022, hands down. One of my top punk records from 2022. Last new punk record I bought. So by new, I went with 2022. So the last record from 2022 that I picked up was this Peace Decay full length. Peace Decay do like really good version of like kind of like Japanese influenced hardcore punk. They're not Japanese. I think they're an American band, but they do really good like kind of like melodic dueling guitar leads and stuff, but over top of like some really like good raw sounding DD. Very good band. Really enjoy this record. I think I'm gonna listen to this next. So when this record's over, if we make it to the end of this one, I'm gonna put this on. This is a great record. If you get a chance, check it out. It's on Beach Impediment Records. Excellent stuff, though. I'm probably going to speed through these a bit, just because I've been making 20-minute videos for these, and I don't know why that is. I just talk too much, I guess. Next up, Punk Grail that I picked up from 2020 in 2022. I showed one, so I'm not going to show that one again, but I picked up another one that was kind of a grail of mine. I sold this in the early 2000s and finally found another replacement copy at an affordable price. and that was NFC Rock and Roll Babylon. This was high on my list to get another copy, and I wasn't specifically looking for an LP. I prefer having LPs. Obviously, I prefer vinyl, but I'm not opposed to getting a CD or a tape. I actually bought a couple other NFC tapes this year, too. But this one I found on LP made me super happy. This is my favorite of the NFC stuff, even though I do love their other stuff. My favorite NFC. And really glad that I could find another copy of this to throw in the collection. Great record. Great, like, Motorhead, discharge-worshipping punk rock stuff with a little bit of, like, rock and roll, heavy metal rock and roll feel to it. Great stuff. Next question. A loaded reissue. So, this is a reissue that's loaded with extra stuff. I don't know if this counts, but this is what I'm doing. I'm doing this one anyway. This is how I'm going. Syphilitic Vaginas. They're not Japanese. I think they're Finnish, but they're pretending to be Japanese. Great band. Finnish or Swedish, I'm not sure. I don't remember. Great band. They do, like, blackened thrash, D-beat, all mixed together. Great band. They do excellent stuff. This is a Nuclear War Now release. It's a double LP. It collects pretty much everything they've put out. Great stuff. This thing's just stacked. I thought of another one I could have did that does have a bunch of extras. The La Peste one that I picked up. Should have put that in there. But this is good. This works. This does the job. Great, great metallic punk stuff. Metallic D-beat. Super black metal-y D-beat stuff. This is great. Can't go wrong with this record. Bought from a gig. Got a 7-inch here from one of my favorite bands. This is Tarantula. I saw these guys live at a festival my friends were putting on. The Philly Still Fucking Shreds Fest. They used to put it on every year until the pandemic hit, and then they kind of had to back off on it, and they haven't done another one since, which I hope they do, but we'll see. But Tarantula, I picked this up from their gig. First time I heard them, I saw them live, and I was like, shit, that band rules, I have to pick it up. And then I found out later that it's The Remnants of Kulu, which I also love that band too, so. But yeah, Tarantula, good stuff. It's kind of like a more rock and roll-y, slowed down version of Kulu. But this is excellent. Picked this up from the gig. Great artwork on all the Tarantula and Kulu stuff. But yeah, this is a great record. Power Pop or Power Violence? I went with Power Violence. And I went with... I have a picture disc here. And it's one of the bands that pioneered were one of the first bands that he termed Power Violence. And that's Man is the Bastard. Thoughtless picture disc. This has some issues. It's a little scratched up. But it still plays. Picture discs don't have the best sound anyway, or they're infamous for not having the best sound. So, but yeah, we're gonna go with this one. And I went with Power Violence. Man is the Bastard. Thoughtless. And Man is the Bastard, it's weird that they're considered Power Violence in my mind, at least, because they basically. Most of their recordings don't have any guitar in it, and they're kind of on the slower side. They don't really do that super fast stuff, but they do have, like, sludgy dirges they go into. One of my favorite bands, too. I love that band. But, yeah, great stuff. Local band. I went with... War X Games. War Games, War X Games, there, however, whatever you pronounce it as. They feature this guy right here is the owner of Celebrated Summer Records, which is my usual local shop. So I decided to show their records. This is kind of a, they're a straight edge band, but they play like a more like harder edged, like punky hardcore sound. They definitely have a lot of hardcore influence, but he's a hardcore guy pretty much. But it's like old school sounding, and it's also got like a little bit of like that punky hardcore, like DB, a little DB'd in there and stuff. So it doesn't sound like a straight edge posy hardcore thing at all. This is really, they're really good actually. Like, it's a really good band. I really enjoy this band stuff. But check them out if you get a chance. War X Games, local band. There it is. Anti-fascist straight edge right there. But yeah, great stuff. And like I said, gotta support, he's the owner of my favorite shop in Baltimore, Celebrated Summer, so I had to support him. Against War is also a 7-inch. And I picked Mankind. Mankind's kind of an anarcho group. They're from the 90s, Connecticut in the 90s. They just put out a discography this year, but I picked this 7-inch. I have all the 7-inches. Won't you join the army now so you can fight and you can die? That's the name of the song. So very anti-war. Great stuff. Mankind. One of my favorites. This is one of my oldest records too. I've had this thing forever. I've had this since I was a teenager, and this is one that I never brought myself to sell. I've had this since I was probably like 16 years old. Split. This one was also kind of a grail for me, but it's a boot, so that's why it didn't really end up as a grail. And I'm removing the string because I usually don't keep that on. I don't know how it ended up staying on there. But these are two classic bands, Chaos UK and Deathside. This is kind of not the strongest Chaos UK stuff, but it's good US Chaos. It's good Chaos UK stuff. The Deathside side is more what I was looking for in this, but this is a great record. It's a Noise Not Music Press. Got this from a buddy's distro. And pretty sick. Gotta say, I was super stoked to get this. He put it up on his distro and I grabbed it right away. One of my top records that I wanted. I'm trying to collect as much Death Side stuff as I can because they're one of my favorites and they're a beast of a band. And I'm a sucker for Japanese hardcore, and that's like, they kind of like epitomize Japanese hardcore sound to me in my brain, but maybe not to everybody, but to me, they're like the epitome of the Japanese hardcore sound. Definitely in the Burning Spirits camp, they're like the epitome. White DIY label. This was also a 2022 release. One I was stoked when I heard it was coming out, but that's Warthog's new EP. Warthog is a great band from Brooklyn, New York. I think I've showed this on the channel before, so. Yeah, but see, white label, that's a stamp. It's not printed. They hand stamped all these. Really excellent stuff. Oh, hand screen printed all this stuff. And I think, yeah, they hand screen printed. Yeah, this is all screen printed too. Screen printed labels, screen printed jacket, screen printed poster. Very DIY. Great band. Definitely one of my favorite hardcore bands coming out, putting out new music right now. Record stopped, so I'm gonna go flip it. Or you know what? Let's give you guys a little taste of that Peace Decay record. How about that? Put that on for the rest of this thing. Be right back. All right, back. Let's go. Next one. VCLT gift or stolen. Got a couple VCLT ones that I wanted to show. One I left up there. Sorry about that. But this one I got from Jason Skills, which Jason, I still intend on doing your cassette tag, but it was the last one I saw, so it's the last one I'm gonna do. So later this week, maybe tomorrow, I might do the cassette tag as well. So sorry, everybody who's sick of the tags. This will be my last one, I promise. And then it's back to our regularly scheduled program. But he sent me this Tristess Barra Rock and Roll EP. It's a great record. It's really good, just straightforward punk. I really enjoyed it. They're a Swedish band. Umea Punk is what it says on here somewhere. Umea 2006. So, one of my favorite bands is also, and one of my favorite Swedish bands, DS13, is also a band from Umea. I don't know if these guys have anything to do with it. I should probably know that, but I don't. But this is on Kick and Punch Records from Copenhagen, Denmark. But this is great. Like I said, straightforward punk rock stuff, but really good, really well done. I enjoyed this one a lot, Jason, so I just wanted to say thanks, put you in the video. But this was a great record. And also, from another homie from Canada, it's Disc Donut, Glazed and Confused. My buddy Uncommon Power, Mike, sent me this in the mail earlier this year, and I loved it. I think this is such a fun, like, one-man project. It's all drum machine D-beat, but very well done and really fun. All the lyrics are donut-themed, which makes it really interesting and fun, so I really loved this thing, so great stuff. Great stuff. Thanks both you guys for sending stuff to me. It really means a lot when people do that. And I'm going to try and do that a little more. Start picking stuff up to send to people when I find stuff for, you know, good price. I'm a cheapskate. I buy things cheap for myself. So if you get something from me, I probably found it for cheap. I'm not going to lie. next up. Looking like that's all LPs from here on out. I think it's not sure whether it's a 33 or 45 record. This one I also kind of cheated on, but not really. It was this Kika Lupin Sukaputo record. Finnish band, hardcore punk stuff. Their records are always really cheap for some reason. Ooh, I don't know why I got all froggy. But their records are always really cheap for some reason, but they're a really good band. They're fast, D-beat style drums and stuff like that. Just really good. But this, one side is 33 and one side's pressed at 33 and one side's pressed at 45, which is really weird. I don't have a lot of records like that. I think I have one other one that's a 7-inch, and I don't remember what it is. But this is pretty much the only record I've ever seen do that, besides maybe some random one I have in there, I think. But really good punk hardcore stuff. But I was really confused the first time I put this on. So I was like, wait a minute, what's going on? Because the first side, I think, is 33 and it sounds fine. And then you put the second side on and you're like, wait, did they just like completely change styles? Or is this a 33 on one side, 45 on the other? But it is 33 on one, 45 on the other. So interesting stuff. Next is Tribute or Comp. This one is a tribute and a comp. It's this Doused in Mud, Soaked in Bleach comp. Great comp that's a tribute to Nirvana. Really good stuff on here. Defeater's good, Val, Beach Slang, Basement. This Will Destroy You is a great band, Young Widows, Mean Jeans. So it's not all punk bands, it's some like indie rockish bands, metal bands. Daughters is on here, so. But really, really good stuff. This is a great comp. Really good covers of all the songs. Interesting Not just like straightforward. Doesn't sound like you're just listening to somebody play Nirvana songs. The band's really like made the songs their own for this, which is really great, which is the best way to hear covers in my opinion. Because if you're just hearing like somebody regurgitate the same song over again, and it doesn't have any of the personality of the band in it, it's kind of boring and it doesn't really do anything for me. But this was great. This is a great comp. And I'll link a list of these in the... I'll put at least a list. I might not do all the links this time. They just take forever. But I'll at least... At first, I'll at least put a list of what I picked for all these categories. Most anticipated for 2023. I just saw the Chisel on Friday. They started playing new songs. So if they put out an album 2023, that will be my most anticipated album. They said they're working on a new album in their banter, but I don't know if it's 2023 or not. But if that's coming out in 2023, that is my most anticipated album. So there you go. A new Chisel album would be my most anticipated. I don't know anything that is coming out. I'm not that up on what's new coming out. I try to be, but I'm not. There's nothing really that's sticking in my brain right now. My pick for Audiophile Suckers. What I picked for the Audiophile Suckers, I picked some noisy Pittsburgh punk hardcore stuff, Eel. I don't remember what the name of this. I don't know. Poison Nuclear Death, is that the name of the album? I don't know. But Eel, noisy D-beat from Pittsburgh. Dude sings with a grinder against the microphone. So definitely going to burst some eardrums and some audio files, I think. Just really raw, harsh punk rock stuff. Eel, that would be my pick. This Eel album right here. Looking like I have to flip that record again. It's a short one. But we'll put on the rest of that. And then the last three or four. I think it's the last three are coming on. So yeah, I still made it to 20 minutes, but that's all right. All right. What do we got left? We've got, five more questions? Pin or patch to grab the thing. So, I just pulled my jacket because I've got a bunch of pins and patches on there. Got my my denim jacket, my denim punk rock jacket here. Chubby and the Gang, Cox Bar. This here pin here is the one I really wanted to show you. I'm Your Turbo Lover. Just a mashup of two of my favorite things, Mad Max and Judas Priest. A couple more of my lose pin. Big Boys and a gauze back patch, of course. But yeah, so yeah, just show my jacket. That pin is done by a local artist. Goes by Flower Violence something on Instagram. I'll look it up and put it in the description. But she does all kinds of cool stuff. They do a lot of cool stuff. They do a lot of cool mashup pins and they do a lot of flyers for local punk shows and stuff like that. Next is Punk Record Defines Punk for Me. Now, I could have went a couple ways with this, but I went with one of the earliest punk records that defined punk for me. And a term that still sticks in my head because I'm in the old 90s punk from Philadelphia. Philly Shreds, Volume 1 on Skookle Records. A lot of my favorite punk bands from an early age, like Violent Society, Rizzo Machine, Dis Sucks, The Boils, Flag of Democracy, all these great Philly punk bands on here. It's a perfect comp, not a bad song on here. Just really excellent stuff. Dead Alive, Subjugation, great, great punk record. And it's also very, like, DIY, done very DIY. Like, some, has a little 7-inch in there, that's part of the comp, but very basic labels. Skookle Records, Philadelphia. It's got screen printed covers. So this is a plain white sleeve with a screen printed cover, and they slapped a glued, this is just like a glued photocopy on the back, but really excellent stuff. And really one of the first punk records that I ever bought that was legit, like, DIY punk stuff. And it's a legendary Philadelphia comp, this Philly Shreds comp. Great stuff. I still play this like 2 or 3 times a year at least. This thing gets busted out and spun because it's like pure nostalgia, pure punk rock for me. Philly Shreds comp, Skookle Records. Record that makes me want to break stuff. That would be, for now, I'm just going to do Hiatus. Hiatus's Brain LP. This is just a fast rager of a freaking B-beat album. Kind of crusty, but like, they really sped it up on this and tightened up, threw some thrash riffs in here. This is an awesome record. I think it's a totally underrated record, but this thing makes me want to like go out and destroy things every single time. Hiatus. They're self-titled, but everybody, because of the brain on the front, everybody calls it the Brain LP. Great record. Also on Profane Existence and Scald, another Profane Existence Scald release, but excellent stuff. Hiatus Brain LP. Too noisy even for me. I'm gonna go with some of these Unholy Grave records. They're recorded live or really with, yeah, this is recorded and mixed, but a lot of their records they just kind of like threw together really fast, and they've done 1,000 splits with people, but some of those recordings are just like really put together and they sound like absolute garbage. And that's the kind of stuff that like I like, but at the same time it has to be in the mood for it. I have to have the feeling for that. But Unholy Grave Records, this is the only Unholy Grave record I own, and I think this one is actually decent. This one has a decent mix on it. But yeah, you could definitely hear when they're just like, oh, we have to put something out, let's just go record something and throw it on there. And then a lot of their stuff is like unmixed and stuff. But I do like Unholy Grave a lot, but some of their stuff does get too noisy for me. Last but not least, record to piss off, the vinyl and the VC Inspector. And I go with Skit Kids, which from Sweden, which translates to shit kids. And it's Anna for Pleasure, so it's all about jagging off, the cover at least. So I think he probably wouldn't like that too much. It was a little picture of a monkey masturbating. Yeah, I don't think he'd like that too much. Plus, it's a band called the Shit Kids. So, but what Skit Kids play is really great D-beat with a little bit of a Motorhead edge to it. That classic, like, kind of a classic Swedish sound to it, too. But really excellent stuff. They play fast and aggressive. Very good stuff. Skit Kids, an excellent band. And this is probably my favorite EP of theirs. I need to get the Shit Fucked by the State LP, which also probably Vinyl Inspector probably wouldn't like that one either. But I think that's the one that's going to piss the Vinyl Inspector off, because it's loud, fast, and honestly, they're not a very well-known band either, so I mean, it's not like a Pink Floyd or anything like that, so I don't think he likes that stuff too much. But anyway, thanks for watching. Punk Vinyl Tag. How the hell did I make this a half an hour long? I have no idea, but it is what it is. Cheers, everybody.